hole in magnetic field causes rare pink aurora above Norway. Nature occasionally provides us with breathtaking images that are equally lovely and unpredictable. The sun can illuminate the clouds and sky as it sets during the Earth's transition from night to day, resulting in an eerily beautiful color. Because the human eye can distinguish green more easily than other colors, most auroral displays are mostly green. Recent directions include the rare pink aura. Most auroras are green, which is the hue of oxygen atoms being irradiated by energetic particles 100 to 300 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. When powerful space particles hit nitrogen molecules at altitudes below 100 kilometers, they produce pink. Stay tuned till the end to hear more about the pink aurora discovered in Norway. A solar storm on November 3rd temporarily damaged the magnetic field of Earth. Because of the ensuing hole, energetic particles could enter the planet's atmosphere far enough to trigger the highly unusual pink auroras. However, experts are dubious if this strange event was a new breed of aurora brought on by the damaged magnetosphere or if it was the product of something else. In this video, we will learn what an aurora is, how it develops, and various scientific theories on the rare pink aurora. Make sure to watch all the way through. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more information before proceeding. Click the bell icon to receive notifications of new videos. Have you already done this? Let us start the celebration. An aurora is a beautiful natural light display in the sky. Lights in blue, red, yellow, green, and orange move and shape change subtly, like softly billowing curtains. Auroras are only visible at night and typically in lower polar areas. Near the Arctic and Antarctic circles, located approximately 66.5 degrees north and south of the equator, auroras can be seen virtually every night. In the north, the spectacle is known as the Aurora Borealis, or Northern Lights. It is referred to as the Southern Lights or Aurora Australis in the south. The fundamental nature of auroras. A few details regarding the space surrounding our planet were necessary before we can comprehend auroras. Many things are hidden in this region that we cannot see. The air we breathe, or our atmosphere, is one thing. In reality, it consists of various gases, primarily nitrogen and oxygen, with traces of hydrogen, helium, and other molecules. Another component that surrounds the Earth that we cannot see is its magnetic field. Plasma, a substance consisting of many charged particles, is a third, invisible object of the space surrounding the Earth. The magnetic field is always filled with positive ions and electrons. In a magnetic field, charged particles move differently because the field guides them. The particles move in a lengthy spiral around the magnetic field lines, moving along them like wires. An aurora uses charged particles as its munition. Display powered by solar. The magnetic field lines push highly electrically charged particles, mainly electrons, into the upper atmosphere, where they hit with gas atoms and produce light. This is a brief explanation of how the aurora occurs. However, why does that occur? We need to gaze farther out to the sun to discover the solution. What is known as the solar wind is what generates the magnificent great aurora seen in what do they look like. The sun also has a space-extending atmosphere and magnetic field. Hydrogen, which makes up the hydrogen in the sun's atmosphere, comprises protons and electrons at the subatomic level. These subatomic particles regularly erupt from the sun and stream away at incredible speeds. Solar wind refers to the magnetic field in particles produced by the sun. The Earth's magnetic field experiences constant pressure from this wind, altering its shape. It takes energy to compress the Earth's magnetic field. Auroras are powered by the energy that the solar wind is constantly building up in the magnetosphere. The magnetosphere of the Earth is being squeezed by the solar wind, and charged particles are dispersed across the field. Solar wind-derived particles constantly travel toward the sun when they enter the magnetosphere's tail. When the circumstances are appropriate, the solar wind's pressure buildup occasionally causes the magnetosphere's tail and the poles to experience an electric voltage similar to that between a battery's two terminals. It has a 10,000-volt maximum voltage. Similar to how electrons in a TV picture tube accelerate to hit the screen, the voltage forces electrons, which are very light, toward the magnetic poles, accelerating them to tremendous speeds. They accelerate northward and southward down the field lines toward the Earth, pushing massive quantities of electrons into the ionosphere, the upper layer of the atmosphere. Speeding electrons smash forcefully with gas atoms in the ionosphere. The gas atoms are given energy, which allows them to release light and additional electrons. In this maneuver, the ionosphere's gases emit light and allow electric currents to travel into and out of the polar zone. The quick arriving electrons had much energy, but the electrons flowing back out were not as energetic because that energy we used to create the aurora. The aurora functions similarly to a neon sign, except that the conducting gas is located in the ionosphere rather than a glass tube, and the current travels over magnetic field lines rather than copper wires in the aurora. When do auroras in various colors, such as yellow, blue, and so on, occur? Depending on the type of atoms involved in the altitude, the aurora has a variety of colors. High in the atmosphere, ions can interact with oxygen atoms to produce a red light. The most common aurora, a green-yellow color, happens when ions strike oxygen at lower altitudes, making this uncommon. Ions striking nitrogen atoms result in the reddish and bluish light frequently visible in the bottom fringes of auroras. Though we rarely see this region of the electromagnetic spectrum with our eyes, ions impacting hydrogen and helium atoms can result in blue and purple auroras. Earth's magnetic field, the magnetosphere, is momentarily deformed by the plasma flow brought by geomagnetic storms, which causes an accumulation of energy on the night side. Charged particles spiral toward the poles after this energy is released. These charged particles' behavior is what gives an aurora its beautiful colors, depending on whether the particles come into contact with air, nitrogen, or oxygen, and where these collisions occur. Various colors are released. Particles slow down and transmit some energy when they collide with an atom or molecule in the atmosphere. Only a very small amount of this energy can be stored by the molecules before the majority of it is radiated away as light. We see these as distinct colors because the wavelength of the light is specific to the atom or molecule. Green light is frequently emitted as energy when particles strike oxygen molecules, due to the high concentration of oxygen molecules at altitudes between 100 and 200 kilometers, where most solar particle collisions occur, this is the auroral color that is most frequently observed. Charged particles often interact with nitrogen molecules at altitudes below 100 kilometers, emitting blue and red colors. The purple edge of a green aurora shape can be created by combining these. A crack in the magnetic field brought on the recent pink aurora that appeared over Norway. The night sky above Norway was recently illuminated by an outburst of highly uncommon pink auroras as a solar storm slammed into Earth and tore a breach into the planet's magnetic field. The break made it possible for extremely intense solar particles to enter the atmosphere further than usual, resulting in unusually colored lights. A tour party headed by Marcus Verik, a Northern Lights tour operator from the Greenlander Tour Company, opens in a new tab. Based close to Troms, Norway, was able to see the breathtaking light display on November 3rd. According to Verik, the colorful auroras appeared at 6 p.m. local time and persisted for almost 2 minutes. Verik claimed that these pink auroras were the strongest he had ever seen in more than 10 years of giving tours. It was humbling, one person said. Shortly after a little fracture occurred in the magnetosphere, pink auroras began to appear in the invisible magnetic field that surrounds Earth and is produced by the planet's fluid metal core. According to spaceweather.com, scientists discovered the breach after a moderate G1 class solar storm struck Earth on November 3rd. Auroras are created when solar wind, streams of extremely powerful charged particles, pass through the magnetosphere. The magnetic field of the globe shields humans from cosmic radiation. However, the field is naturally weaker near the south and north poles, allowing the solar wind to skim through the atmosphere, typically between 62 and 186 miles, 100 and 300 kilometers, above the planet's surface. According to NASA, Solar particles superheat gases as they travel through the atmosphere, causing them to glow brightly at night. Because oxygen atoms, plentiful in the region of the atmosphere where the solar wind often reaches, produce that color when they are excited, green auroras are the most prevalent type of aurora. According to spaceweather.com, the recent solar storm allowed the solar wind to enter below 62 miles, where nitrogen is the most prevalent gas, because of a gap in the Earth's magnetosphere. As a result of the supercharged particles primarily colliding with nitrogen atoms, the auroras gave forth a vibrant pink hue. Strong green auroras continued to be produced throughout the night due to the Earth's magnetosphere crack, according to Varik. Today's video has come to an end. Remember to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to view more material. Remember to click the bell symbol to receive notifications when new videos are posted. I will see you in the next video.